morning in our weekend house call, WDSU medical editor Dr. Corey Hebert tells us why allergies can strike at any time, at any age.
You may have been able to avoid allergies for decades, when suddenly at age 20 or 30 or older you develop them. It hardly seems fair, but according to research, adult onset allergies are increasingly common. But why? Well, research suggests that many adults actually had allergies as a child, but may have never known it or may have forgotten about them. The allergies subsided as they grew up, but now as people get older and their immune systems weaken, the allergies flare up again. For other adults, repeated exposure to allergens finally sensitizes their immune system. They develop an allergy to cats, for example, after having been a longtime cat lover. Allergies can also develop if a weakened immune system is exposed to allergens. This may occur after a viral infection or during pregnancy. In fact, it's pretty common for women who develop allergies after pregnancy to really be sensitized to them. Then there's the hygiene hypothesis. This theory claims that our immune systems, these remarkable engines designed to fend off assaults from germs, are underused these days. Due to an overuse of sanitizing agents, antibiotics, and our highly germ-free environment, our immune system don't come in contact with disease-causing antigens that our ancestors did. That causes our underused immune systems to turn on our own bodies, creating allergies and autoimmune diseases. The immune system is acting like a stubborn teenager, getting in trouble just because it doesn't seem to be anything else to do around. Actually, adult onset allergies, including allergic asthma, can be treated with antihistamines, antileukotrienes, and nasal cortical steroid sprays. And immunotherapy with shots and sublingual drops can help reset the immune system so the allergic reaction is reduced or even prevented. And allergists can determine what form of immunotherapy is best for you, depending upon the type of allergies that you might have, as well as their severity. Also, because we live in the Gulf South, there's a real issue with seafood allergies, which can be triggered by just smelling seafood. So be careful, and if you've had any of these allergies and you were short of breath, you need to carry a device called an EpiPen. Make sure you ask your doctor to describe one. I'm medical editor Dr. Corey Hebert.